rise to some prominence. In one of her albums, The Book of Secrets, she actually came to our archaeological site in Canciano in Tuscany and hung out with us for a while, trying to embrace the ideas of archaeology and digging up the past. And then she came back and wrote a song, and she came to visit us quite a few years back now, and we were sitting at the Arizona Inn, and she played a song for me on a cassette, and it was an acoustical song, and it was called The Mummer's Dance. And it sounded very nice, and I said, well, you know, this is a disco song. This is a rock song. And she said, well, I don't do rock songs. And we talked for a while, and I said, well, you really have to do this disco style. And disco was very big at the time, and it seemed like a good thing to do. And she said, well, okay, I'll do one disco song, but I'll never do another one. And this song became one of the biggest hits in the world. She made a fortune off of this, and I got two lousy gold records out of it. That's all I got. But I didn't write it. She wrote it. And The Mummer's Dance is a really good example of the kind of music and earth appreciation that she brings in. And I was thinking, as I was looking over it, you know, I just went kind of at random to the MTV, which is very popular with the young people these days, you know. And I got some lyrics of a modern song. The group is called LMFAO. Very interesting name for a group. I wonder what that means. Anyway, so let me just read you the lyrics, because this is the lyrics that we're hearing a lot in songs today. And I think we should give them their due. When I walk on by, girls be looking me like, damn, he fly. I pimp to the beat, walking down the street in my new La Freak. Yeah. This is how I roll, pants out of control. It's red foo with big ass fro. Like Bruce Leroy, I got the glow. Ah. I work out. Girl, look at that body. Ah. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Sometime of this day, and now returning back again, we bring a garland gay. Who will go down to those shady groves and summon the shadows that are there, and tie a ribbon on those sheltering arms in the springtime of the year? That's a lyric she wrote, and that was a top 10 guitar song also, all across the world. And then she made a video to try and mesmerize you into love and appreciation of nature and celebrating the blessings that you have in your life. It was a video about a tradition that they have in Newfoundland, a Canadian tradition, of people who go house to house, renewing the seasons and dressing in earth colors, bearing an image of Jesus with them, and different characters, kings and fools, representing all the different people of the earth. And in producing this video, she became increasingly interested in an Eastern Islamic religious practice in Persia, which was called Sufism. And as part of Sufism, you contemplate your inner being, you become aware of all the parts of your body, you become aware of your responsibility to nature, to earth, and to become elevated and to have a kind of inspirational feeling about you, you whirl, and it creates a kind of dizziness. So you have hypnotic music and whirling like a dervish, like a whirling dervish, to inspire you. And all of this is designed to make you a better individual. Lorena is always talking about polishing the mirror of your soul. You come in, you sit down, you go to a lecture, you go through your daily life, and it doesn't really mean anything to you. Why are you here? Why are you doing this? What do you take from it? What are you going to do with your life? How are you going to respond to your world? What things are going on that you have to fix in order to be true to nature, this debt of nature, so that people in the future can have a life? Your offspring, what are they going to be like? What are they going to have as opportunities? All of these things are part of these videos that she makes. So she does them in earth tones, and she wants you to revere the past, to think about the past. So when you look at it, you look at it as if you're looking at an old, choppy movie, something that isn't really kind of real anymore. And so the video just sort of interrupts periodically and chops along like it's something old and beautiful and forgotten that she's calling back to mind. So that's what it was. And my lone contribution to it was to say, don't just do it acoustically, make it really, really rock. And so that's what she did. She really goosed it up and rocked it. And so I thought, before we play it right now, here's my sole contribution to the history of music. Lorena McKennitt's wonderful Mummer's Dance. Enjoy.
Trees are crowded.
So listen to your friends and think good thoughts. We'll see you next time. Bye.